We're here at the Kiel Golf Centre with 2G Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we're talking warm versus cold golf balls. And we played in some pretty cool conditions here in the UK, Neil.
Yeah, those winter months, obviously, the winter nights get very, very cold here. Guys will leave golf clubs in the car boot overnight, shed, guys, whatever, them golf balls are in the bag, obviously going to be very, very cold. And then on the flip side, we're playing warmer conditions well in the summer, so it's going to be interesting to see how the data compares.
We're really inquisitive here at TG, and we really wanted to find out how much difference the cold really affects a golf ball by. So we've had Neil hit a driver, an iron and a wedge, and we're going to show you how they all compare and what you give up when the weather is very, very cold. Just to tell you a little bit about how we've done this, we've kept all of the cold golf balls in a fridge overnight, and then we've transported them here to Neil in a cool bag, and which has been wrapped in ice. And then also on the warm golf balls, we've had them wrapped up in a warm blanket, and we've transported them here on a heated car seat. So there is quite a difference in temperature. And also, it was a pretty cool day that we actually did the test on there.
Yeah, it certainly was.
And just to add in that we've done all of this test using premium golf balls, so it's very comparable data compared to what you will see actually on the golf course in reality. Okay, let's move on and let's see how all of these golf balls compare. Right, Neil, we always knew there was quite a big difference between hot and cold golf balls, but just talk us through the raw data here.
Yeah, thank you, Sam. The first thing that strikes me is the ball speed is up in every category with your driver, the 7-iron and the pitching wedge with a warm golf ball. Mm. So that speaks volumes, really. I mean, look at this, the 287 carry with a warm golf ball with a driver over a 279 with a cold golf ball, which is huge, really. I know it might not sound much, but if you think about the combined of these two, Simon, the driver and the 7-iron, so I've gained, there was 180 yards with a warm 7-iron, 173 yards with a cold golf ball with a 7-iron. That's a combined yardage of 15 yards, which is huge, really.
Yeah.
Think of the difference that's going to make on a golf course for a lot of guys.
Yeah, that really is a big difference, isn't it? You know, and it does make a huge difference when it comes to actually performing on the golf course. Mm. And we've got some pretty interesting stats here. So across the driver, the 7-iron and the wedge, the warm golf balls were 2.5 miles an hour faster. That's a pretty big gain.
Yeah, that, like I say, it's amazing the difference in, I'm going to be honest, I wasn't expecting that big a jump, really, but that can change your golf game, really, especially on these, like, if you're at the borderline to reach par fives, even flying over a bunker on those longer par fours, going in with less golf club, which we know now with the modern game, you hit it further, you know, better chance of shooting lower numbers. So it needs paying attention to, really.
Okay, and 15 yards gain between the driver and the 7-iron, that to most people is a really, really big gain by keeping your golf ball warm.
Huge, yep. Definitely. So if you ever got to think of this in scenarios, maybe winter or something, Simon, guys that can save the golf ball in the pocket, keep it as warm as possible. If you wear winter mittens, hand warmer in there, get the golf ball in there as well. Just give yourself the best opportunity to shoot the best scores. Don't be at a disadvantage having this golf ball being freezing cold, because you really are putting yourself on the back foot.
Absolutely. And some standout numbers really on the wedge as well, because quite a few people wouldn't really expect a cold wedge ball to spin more than a warm wedge ball. But we've seen this before. A nice firm golf ball with a full wedge tends to spin more than what a softer golf ball will. But only on the full wedge shot, not on short shots, you know, around the green.
That's it.
So it's nearly 800 RPM more with the colder golf
Which
ball.
Which I was in the category where I was a bit surprised by that. But yeah, like I say, that's another thing that guys have got to consider. You've got to adapt yourself to these conditions. But like I say, give yourself the better opportunity. Another thing we need to mention, Simon, is that colder golf balls coming in a little bit lower. So lower peak height, shallower descent angle, harder to stop into the green. Mm-hmm. It's going to have an effect on how you're going to score.
Yeah. And across the bag, you know, that is a big difference with the driver, with the iron,
definitely,
with the wedge, with the flight. You know, it really is a big difference. So what are the key takeaways from this? You know, to me, it just says keep your golf ball warm. So absolutely do not leave your golf equipment in the boot of your car if you know that it's going to be a cold and frosty evening.
Yeah. You've got to give yourself, like I've just said, guys, you've got to give yourself the best opportunity to play your best golf. And if you're using a cold golf ball, you're definitely not doing that.
Right, there's loads of information there, guys. If you've liked the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below. We promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.